your weather, as you just heard, 33.3 degrees. Wind 6 miles an hour out of somewhere. Last night, Aurora Borealis in my neighborhood and nobody called. I can't believe it happened again. Very disappointing. Apparently they were quite lovely. Forecast is pretty good for today. Coming up a little bit of rain or snow, but, you know, really nothing big to shovel. We're so grateful for travelers, etc. Barometer steady at 30.52. Your question of the day. Yesterday, Jeff was hip deep in the dishwasher and taking every part that would disconnect out of the bottom and taking the gunk off the filters and the basket and the whirligig air, what are they, water sprayer. Everything he could move that he could get a toothpick in, he cleaned. That's the question of the day. Do you, have you ever cleaned the gunk out of your dishwasher filter? Okay. Let's stand. Oh, stand by for emergency. I'm sorry. Hearing none, we will march ahead and look for short time going to work. Mobile or otherwise soon out of range, please identify yourself now.
KA9ARZ. Alpha Bravo 9, November, November. KMA and the good morning. Up, this is KA9ARZ. Very good morning to do a quick reset, make sure I'm getting the repeater or not doubling. A9ARZ returning, ready to head out the door and full day of work. Shooting action photos this evening at a basketball game, and hopefully everyone attending the Green Bay Mike and Key Christmas party dinner tonight. Be able to get some action photos from there. Of course, ham radio events where you can get your best action photos there. And hopefully Rick got the phone camera and get some action photos there, or Bob or whoever might be in attendance. And speaking of Rick there, too bad you weren't featured on the intro to Monday Night Football, banging on the drums there. It'd been kind of neat seeing you there. But anyways, hopefully Rick will be able to come through with some action photos tonight at the get-together there. So, have a dishwasher here, but don't deal with it. Wouldn't have enough of dishes to go through the numbers, and you don't even think the one here probably even functions anymore there. So don't mess with that as far as the question of the day goes. So, with that, over to the other side of the lake, see how the dishwashers and the weather are going on the other side of Lake Michigan with AB9NN. This is KA9ARZ. Good morning, all.
Good morning to everybody on the Good Morning Net from John, AB9NN, in Beulah, Michigan, Northwest Florida, Michigan, straight across the pond from Algoma and 9 miles inland. And let's see, to answer the question of the day right away before I forget about it. No, I never have cleaned out the dishwasher filter, surprisingly. It's a good thing to bring up and remind us of, and probably something should dig into. Let's see, wanted to get in early this morning because I've got a routine medical appointment in Traverse City that I need to go to, and the appointment's at 11 o'clock, so I need to be out of here by 10, so I wanted to make sure that I get my Good Morning Net greetings in and done with and dispatched with so that I can get dressed and get out of here by 10. So that's the reason for that. Let's see, as far as what's going on weather-wise, 40.9 degrees, which is not too cool. southwest wind at 9.2 miles an hour, and looks like we've got mostly to partly sunny skies over northern lower Michigan, and clouds moving through to the southeast from some of the eastern parts of northern lower Michigan. Solar flux index is down to 135, and let's see. I was listening to 80 meters last night for the UPNet on my RTLSGR radio dongle, and boy, the band just took a dive. I listened till about 5:30, and the band just took a dive and turned into nothing but static. So that was kind of disappointing. We'll see. I think the solar flux index has peaked up just a little bit, so maybe that'll bring up the 80-meter propagation. Not much else going on. Just reading the book on Henry Winkler. It's a good, very good, interesting read into his background and his childhood days and that sort of thing. So very well-written book and enjoying that. With that, I guess it's back over to Net Control from AV9NN. John and Beulah, have a great day, everyone.
Thank you very much, and have a good day. There are five on EchoLink at the moment, and we will get to you. And then let's take all over-the-air RF check-ins. Please come now.
This is Kilo Alpha Niner, Whiskey Alpha Romeo, K9DXG. W9OBB.
Okay, the list for over the air, WARBSG, OBB, 9T, UPE, and LNZ. And then now we'll go to EchoLink first, and the order will be Michelle, K9GU, and then you send it to Jack, KA9TQC. Jack, over to Steve, W9MCU, welcome back. And then Steve, over to Larry, KB9DIP. And then Larry, over to Alan, G1AEU. Alan, over to K9WAR, your friend Artie. Okay, good morning, everyone. Let's hear about your dishwashing experiences. Good morning, Michelle.
Nicely in here. So that's the answer to your think it maybe that we will have to go for a little errand to pick up some food in here that we don't really have right now. It doesn't seem to be very important at this point, but I think we should not forget to do it in here. Anyway, I'll bet you don't think KMI, I think you see. Good morning, Jack. This is the KMI-G. All of you have a good day.
That's all I've got, and now the lady
you've been waiting for. You know him, you love him. The Jazz Gentleman from the UK, Slammin' L. G1AEU. Kyle, your turn, take it away.
good morning.
And it is looking like a pretty nice day out. Looks get pretty warm out, so that's nice. Hopefully I'll get outside and enjoy it a little bit. And really nothing too much. A friend of mine, I talk on the radio with once in a while, stop by, and my brother had a mortising unit that he bought last summer and never used it. This guy has a big project for the mortising, so I was able to get it from my brother and loan it out to him. So hopefully all works out well for it. He's making a kitchen table and he needs it done. For a dishwasher, well, every once in a while, they say each dishwasher and a wash machine, you run some vinegar through it. Not a lot, just some. And it's supposed to help clean things up. We have a lot of iron in our water. Even though we run the softener and everything else, the rust still comes through. So every once in a while, I go with a little vinegar in spots and pour it on there, let it sit for a while. Tends to help a lot. And no, never took out the filter. Don't even know where to look for the filter, and I don't plan to. This dishwasher has a limited time life here. It's going to be going away in a couple of months. It's quite certain. So, otherwise, nothing's dull. I'm gonna have to do a little plumbing here for gas. Gonna be changing to a gas stove instead of electric. So I have to run a gas line over to it. And it's not that far, and hopefully it won't be too much work. Probably going to take less than 10 feet. So we'll send it over to Rick, OBBK9DXG.
Thank you, Bob. Good morning. W9OBB here, Green Bay. And Bob, it sounds like you're helping out others again. Your mortising machine there, and hope everything goes well with that. Been in the middle of working on my boat here, trying to get that done. I'm into the fiberglassing part of it, but I'm still doing my my test to get it down just right. To Kevin, the Christmas party, I will try to remember to take some photos. I'm sure Bob will as well. Should be a good time over there. Looking forward to that. So is Sue. And as far as the dishwasher goes, I've never really thought of going into the sump and looking at that filter down there. But my wife usually has the dishes pretty clean before they even go in the thing. So I don't think there's a whole bunch that collects there. At least it hasn't been that way in the last 45 years. And I haven't had problems with that. Replaced a couple dishwashers, but that was due to parts wearing out. And so that's the deal with that. Probably a good idea, though. Not a bad idea to maybe look down there once in a while. And Jack brought up a good point with the hose that leads over to, connects to, in our case, it connects to the garbage disposal, so got to make sure that thing gets up at the right level. There's a big anti-siphon loop in there, and want to make sure that stays that way. You don't want that other water going the other way. So, okay, not much else here to cover. And I think with that, I'm going to pass it over to Damien, AG9T, W9OBB. Good morning to all.
AG9T, O'Connell. We're not allowed to use the dishwasher here. I think the reason is Cynthia has expensive dishes, so never get cleaned or used. It's a nice one. But my lifetime of experiences with dishwashers, once you start having problems with them and fix something else goes wrong. That's the one tell clients that when you start having problems, at least I always buy a new one. On our wash machine, I'm doing a wash machine here on the second floor today with all of our shirts she bought me. Anyways, the hot water line filter needs cleaning. The water flow of the hot side is not up to par, but I won't get to that this year. Let's see, for the Food Network, instead of smoked chubs this morning, I got shrimp because Cynthia has a Christmas party at noon at work, and she brought nothing but these big shrimp. And tonight is the Mike and Keith Club party. I bought a gift for there, that white elephant stuff. I'll tell you about it tomorrow, but I hope I get it back. It's a nice, nice machine. Let's see. Oh, Cynthia had a bad day at work yesterday, which is normal with her caseload. Three trips to the jail yesterday alone, and, you know, you ask them a question, oh, I don't remember, that's the answers you get out of these criminals. Let's see, what else? Oh, so I fixed her the $22 a pound filet last night. She didn't know what it was, but she mentioned how tender it was. You didn't need a knife. Over to, oh, Bob, we're bringing you three jars tonight, PXG, but we don't need refills yet. HE9P over to UPE.
So, thank you, Damien. Good morning to you, and good morning to everyone on the net. This is JD9UPE. Question of the day. The dishwasher filter, I don't pay, I admit to not paying much attention to it. I've been involved in moving or replacing or working on the dishwashers 5 or 6 times now. They're never any fun. I don't know what they're up against or what they're doing when installing them begins. Never enough wire, never enough hosing. Just things don't want to work out very well. So unless that filter plugs up, I pretty much ignore it. I stay away from those things because I've installed them before for either new flooring or to move it or new machine. I don't like moving working on those things. So sorry, I missed yesterday, but boy, I overslept a long time. I'm ashamed to even admit it because I couldn't sleep very well the night before. So I've been into a little too much reading and staying up a little too late doing so. And just got myself all out of whack and was sleeping like crazy yesterday. So with that then, and my apologies, I will send it over to Thomas. KC9LNZulu, this is KD9UPE.
Thanks, and good morning to all. KC9LNZulu here. Well, temperature in Kewanee is 33, 34 degrees, a light breeze, and partially sunny skies, so a good start to the day. We'll see how that works out. As far as the question of the day, well, the dishwasher I have is the one that was here when I moved into the house in 2003. And I do clean out the upper filter on a regular basis. And on the lower filter, I check it after each load because I just want to make sure that, you know, if there's some paper or something on one of the appliances, one of the items I put in there, it hasn't fallen off and gotten into there. So I keep that on a regular basis. The washing machine, well, I bought that when I was still living in Connecticut, and that was in 1996, and it still runs really good. I try to do, recently I read a couple articles about cleaning it out every so often, so I'm going to try once a quarter to use the what they say to do with it. It's not very complicated, and it'll run fine, but I don't have a dryer anymore. I gave that away a long time ago. to one of my relatives, as a matter of fact. Their daughter needed it. And I just basically hang dry all my clothes, whether it's wintertime or summertime, it's always hang drying. So it makes some stuff last longer, and I kind of like that. So I've got some chores to do today after the next net I run, and then we'll see what else I can get done out there. So, hey, everybody have a good day. Take care. Just be careful. And, pause for a quick second here. Went to the city office the other day because I got a tax bill, but it was for a person across the street, not mine, and I was worried that maybe mine got dropped somewhere else, and the city said, well, no, we're just passing them out now, and they had a couple of boxes there, and I went to the post office and talked with them, found out the route that was going, and after I got back from the post office and another errand to run, guess what's in the mailbox? The city tax bill. So I guess if you ask questions, they follow up with you. KC9, LN Zulu, back to net control. Good morning to all.
Tom, thank you, everyone. Well, here in Sevastopol, I mentioned before, our taxes actually went down a tiny bit. And when I compare it to the house in Illinois, from the time we lived there 11 years ago until now, it has increased almost 30%. I've got that wrong, but 25% anyway. So we're happy to be here where they're a little more careful with the expenses. First, let's see, Jack. No, we don't have a disposal. It was recommended on septic that you not get one. And this was just routine maintenance. I've read an article, and we experienced a couple years ago just taking up the, in the bottom is a pretty logical assembly. You know, there's a place to put your finger to pull the little filter out. A surprising accumulation of either, I don't know, funk. We'll call it stuff. Because we do a pretty good pre-rinse as well. With the old, very lovely, oh, I loved my KitchenAid dishwasher. It had a food disposal in the washer, so it would grind up whatever was left and flush it out. This does not. And so, you know, whatever's there stays there, and it's just little dust. I mean, it's not big stuff, but they do indicate in this YouTube, you know, how to do it. And this guy goes crazy, pulling everything out and cleaning the gaskets and da-da-da-da-da. But it will lengthen the life of your dishwasher to keep things from being plugged. Ditto for those of you who mentioned your washer and dryer. Getting in behind the filters that supposedly catch all the dust is a shocking amount of dust. So there you go. But guess who's here? I want to know if you've crawled inside of your dishwasher, Josh. But back to Brad. Don't you dare crawl inside your dishwasher. It's a horrible position for your back. Don't do it. Over to Josh, KD9GDA.
Our dishwasher is more like Thank you. I'm gonna get this all about. I didn't double with anybody, John.
but I will try to let you know this is the second to last broadcast of Alan G1EEU. Sounds a little bit like a last episode of Keeping Up Appearances. When his daughter was talking, it sounded that he had all those accents, but they had good memories. Keeping Up Appearances. Oh, I like that show. Anyway, Sean, back to you. Give me an idea, baby.
And we both smiled about that. Steve St. Orge, which I don't think he makes it sound like he's French, but that dryer hose, no kidding, the perforated one is just amazing. You know what I mean, the crinkle is folded. Yes, it is. It's just really not ideal. And so it is, at least once a year, Jeff will go from the inside out and outside in with the long reach, specially designed coat hanger with a hook on it and drag stuff out. And it's a shocking amount of stuff. Excuse me. But here's a shopping tip for the suburb. Here in Sevastopol, I've been on the hunt for Dean's, only Dean's, eggnog. We only like Dean's. We don't like the other brand. We don't like the other brand. And so I was getting a gift card at the hardware store. You know why. Spend $50, get $10 free. You can't fool me. That's 20% off, so I bought a gift card for us. And so while I'm there, next to the checkout, who knew, is a standalone little refrigerator case with a dairy from Appleton having their products. And there on the bottom shelf is homemade, dairy-made, local product eggnog in a half-gallon glass jug. It is 20 pounds, but... okay, we found eggnog. Thank goodness. And when you think eggnog, don't you think Ace Hardware? I do. All right, one last round of comments, and then I don't know what we're doing today. But Jack, let's see what people think about the announcement at the top and bottom of the hour, or top of the hour. Those on a scanner may not want transmissions overnight. I think... they're in the old radio club, they used to do it, and then they stopped doing it. So I don't remember. It doesn't affect us. We don't have a radio on. But those who do, is it helpful or too much is my question. Over to you for a comment if you're still there. KA9TQC. It's bright and sunny and 34.8 degrees, allegedly on its way up to the 40s. So that's what we're going to be doing, running around in the yard probably. KC9 KMA is clear for the day.
Comment, I appreciate temperature and sky conditions like that. I was surprised by it yesterday, but I like that. So I'll vote in favor. KC9, LN Zulu.
Tom, real good. One place heard from, and certainly can get easily done to turn it off or on as you choose. And I will attempt to figure out about this double squelch tail. So that's what I'm going to work on for a few minutes. Everybody have a good day. K9TQC.